You are the one. Okay? You are the one. People are losing their shit. People are panicking. The world is in hysteria. But you are the one who's going to maintain the calm, the cool, the collectedness, the rationality to actually see things for what they really are. Okay? We don't see the world as it is. We see the world as we are. And all of this mainstream media, all of this fear mongering, all of this coronavirus, the real virus is that of the information and energy structure that has been created through human thought, through human emotion, and it's really taken on a life of its own, right? Because when we really look at what is going on over here, it's like, okay, it's a health crisis. It's a health epidemic, right? People are losing their shit. Borders are shutting down. I had to return over here to the motherland right now as well. My travel plans had to change, but when we look at it, okay, it's a health epidemic. Who is really at risk from this health epidemic? Okay, it is probably 10 to 20% of the population that is older or has weakened immune systems, right? Okay, definitely have to watch out for that. Why not quarantine those 20% people and let society function as it's supposed to, right? Why not protect those people and let society function as it's supposed to? Because the reality is, that even if you get the coronavirus, if you're strong, if your immune system is on point, if you are functioning how you're supposed to, then the coronavirus will not really do much other than just help you, or not help you, but hinder you in terms of experiencing symptoms that are associated with the flu, with some respiratory issues, right? Worst case scenario is that that happens and you develop an immunity to it and eventually pass that on as well, right? So we see that it's a health issue going on right now, but behind the scenes, what is actually the issue right now? Who's really going to suffer from this? Well, it's really an economic play over here, right? Small businesses, medium businesses, restaurants, hotels, all of these businesses are really not going to be able to follow through on providing value to the marketplace, and therefore they're going to go down. So really, it's an economic play going on over here. There's a lot that can be said about what the game is being played, but at the end of the day, realize that you are the one. Okay, now what does this mean? This means that all of your experiences in your life are taking place within your own nervous system, right? Fear is a frequency. And when we tune into that frequency, then we lower our vibration, and therefore we end up fulfilling this agenda, that of fear mongering, of people losing their personal power, of people resorting to this panic mentality and getting trapped in that fear, okay? So realize that everything that you're going through right now, it's taking place within your own nervous system, and you are in charge of how you respond to these events around you. You can maintain your calm, maintain your rationality. Don't react emotionally, right? Create that space between stimulus and response. You see people out there panicking. You see the world. You see the coronavirus, right? But really put yourself in that space of silence. Get close to who you really are. That silence, that eternal aspect of your being. And look at what is actually going on. What is the real play over here? Because the reality is nothing's going to happen to you. You're all good. Your immune system's strong. You're practicing the habits that allow you to stay strong. You're young. You have vitality, right? So why is it that people are panicking over their health? Well, of course, the first thing is this mainstream media. It's like coronavirus. The real virus is the fear virus, right? This whole phenomenon of the coronavirus is the real virus rather than the coronavirus itself. And secondly, realize that it's all you. You are experiencing everything. There is nothing outside of you. There's no people. There's nothing other than your own experience taking place within your own nervous system. And the more you can take control of your own perceptions, the more you can control your experiences, the more you can go ahead and be that pillar of fortitude for the people around you as well. Okay? And really, today is a good day to die. Okay, that's what the Native Americans used to say. Today is a good day to die, because at the end of the day, we're all going the same way. And when we are stuck in survival, right, that lower fear frequency of survival, thinking that we have to survive, we're not getting out of this alive. We're all going the same way at the end of the day. So when we can let go of that survival, because we're not going to survive this life right now, okay, we're all going to transition, we're all going that same way. And once we can realize this, then we can realize that the only thing that's left to do is really to live, right? It's not to survive. We're all gonna die. Just live in the time frame that you have right now, and what you can make do of it. Spread those good vibes, spread those higher ideas, right? Spread the aspect of you that you are actually proud of. Make commitments to yourself. Show up for the people in your life as well, right? So Just a quick message here for you, because just got back to my parents' place, and for me it's really another opportunity to maintain my rationality, because there is this panic. There's no doubt that people are losing their shit, countries are shutting down their borders, like there is chaos going on. The economic system is definitely the one that's taking the major hit, but for us right now this is an opportunity to show up, right, to take control of our own perceptions so that we can control our experiences and really show up as the most capable versions of ourselves rather than reacting to this agenda that is outside of us. Okay, so stay strong, man. You are the one, and always remember that you are one decision away from a totally different life. Much love to you. I'll see you in the next video.